When I was a little bitty boy, just up off the floor, we used to go out to Grandma's house every month in the soul. We'd have chicken pie and country ham, homemade butter on the bread. But the best darn thing about Grandma's house was a great big feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese, took a hole both the cloth for the tick. It hold 8 kids and 4 hound dogs and a piggy we stole from the shed. Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. After supper we'd sit around the fire, the old folks would spit and chew. Pa would talk about the farm and the war, and my granny'd sing a ballad or two. And I'd sit and listen, watch the fire, till the cobwebs filled my head. Next thing I know, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the old feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese, took a whole bolt of cloth for the tick. It hold 8 kids, 4 hound dogs, and a piggy we stole from the shed. Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. I love my pa, I love granny and grandpa too. I've been fishing with my uncle, I wrestled my cousin, I even kissed Aunt Lou. Ooh, but if I ever had to make a choice, I guess it ought to be said that I'd trade them all, plus a gal down the road for grandma's feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese, took a whole bunch of cloth for the tick. It hold 8 kids, 4 hound dogs, and a piggy we stole from the shed. Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.